here with Rosemary Watkins, and I've got a question for you that often comes up in workshops, and it's all around unwanted gifts. So they often get shoved to the back of cupboards, but the people are unable to let go of them because they kind of attach it to the feeling of the person who gave it to them. So people have spoken about feeling guilty or ungrateful that they don't want the gift. But they don't seem to be able to let go enough to donate.
Yes, yep. This is quite a big one, I think. And I can even recall being in touch with some of that myself at various times in my life. It is an important aspect to kind of reflect on, I think, within the self, and to see the what the person has given you is, if it's not of value to you, that you can begin to help them know that somehow. Okay, now as I say that, people will be going, oh, shock, horror,
yeah.
How do you do that?
Difficult.
You know, yeah. But it will call for some assertiveness in your communication and in with your loved ones. And when you might take something once and value that, the way you might speak to it would be something like, you know, really appreciate your thoughtfulness and, you know, thinking of me in that way. But however, this isn't something that I like to collect or I like to use. And so I'm just letting you know, because otherwise you might end up with the same thing every year or something similar,
yeah.
You know, another year. And so you need to call a halt to it somewhere along the line. And that's where the assertiveness can come in speaking up about whether it's what you like or value or not. But also while doing that, appreciating their thoughtfulness and their generosity and whatever, and that, you know, you will donate it somewhere. So you could even tell them that I'm planning on donating it to X, Y, or Z, and then invite them to know another version of that, I guess, is to let them know that that you are in the process of perhaps, you know, really wanting to declutter your life, and that you've become more of a minimalist, or you know, someone that really doesn't like things that are not of value to you, that you can recognize they're of great value to many others, and even to the person who gave it to you, but that to you, you don't place the same value on them. Again, like that challenging conversation I was mentioning earlier, where you invite their side of it and your difference. So this time you might start with your difference on it, and then invite how they're feeling about you sharing that with them, and how they're going, having heard you say that. And if it is about you wanting to be more of a minimalist or decluttering your life, or really coming to a state where you don't want to add extras to it, then you help them to respect, or invite them to respect that choice of yours as just that, as your choice, and no reflection on your love for them or your feelings for them. And in order to do that, you'll have had to come to terms with it in yourself first.
Yes.
And once you've come to terms with your love for them, your value for them, and in without it being attached to something they've given you, and the freedom that comes in really healthy relationships, because in a healthy relationship, it's important that we're free to be real and honest with what is of importance to us, and to have that respected and valued by the other.
And if it's something that's gathering dust at the back of the cupboard, it's been there for years, there's probably no need for that conversation. It's just coming to terms and accepting,
right.
You know, would you agree?
Like, yes,
in
the self,
yeah.
Yes, absolutely,
yeah.
Yeah, that's absolutely spot on. So if it is something there, and you just, it's more coming to terms with yourself around that, and then if you're worried it might occur again, then you might have the conversation.
And it's always good to suggest to people to do experiences, because one thing that we lack is having time with our friends and family. So
yeah.
Saying let's go out for dinner, or let's do something that has nothing to do, especially with a physical item.
Exactly, yes,
yeah.
Yes, very much so. So you can say to them, from now on, my preference for birthdays and Christmas is to have experiences together,
yeah.
Rather than gifts or items. Yeah, I have enough stuff.
Yes,
yeah.
Lovely.
Yeah, excellent.